Australian Open with Talkline.
Hello and a very warm welcome from me, Chris Bradman, to the final day of the Australian Open here at Melbourne Park in Melbourne on the most glorious day. It's about 28 degrees Celsius. It's low to mid-80s. Virtually no wind, the roof very clearly open, and it is all set for what I think will be a cracking match between, in your picture there, Thomas Enqvist, will be 25 in March, against the Russian 24-year-old Yevgeny Kafelnikov, the only seed left in the tournament. In this final, of course, only two men left from 128 starters, and I've got a feeling this is going to be a cracker of a match. Sitting alongside me, Danny Satsford, looking forward to this one as well, Danny?
Absolutely. I don't think it can fail to live up to all expectations. Both players at the height of their form, very, very confident, in great physical shape. Really, really looking forward to this one.
And they've both played very well in the run-up, as we see the massive ball boys and girls, who again I mentioned Jan Howes's name. She's in charge of the ball boys and girls here at the Australian Open. They do a great job. As we see there, the great names that adorn the Australian Open Tennis Trophy. These two men have met six times before, and Thomas Enqvist on the right there leads that head-to-head by 4-2. And interestingly, he's won the last two times they've played, both last year in Marseille and at the French Open. French Open being the last time they played, in the round of 64, and Enqvist winning 6-1 in the fourth set. Two times in a final these two have met, and both times Thomas Enqvist winning, a finalist match in Paris in 1996, winning his ninth title there, and in the final in Marseille last year, Enqvist coming through 6-4, 6-1 to win his 12th title. So maybe making it a hat-trick of wins if he could pull it off here today. And throughout the tournament, Danny, as we just look at Enqvist, starts living in the tax haven of Monte Carlo now, 24 years of age, 6'3", he's a big man. Two titles last year, his Australian Open record, he's won 18 and lost 6, and there his run through, the American in the first round, Byron Black of Zimbabwe in the second. Big match against Rafter, and then Philippoussis knocking out the 1 and 2 in two rounds from Australia, and the giant Swiss man, conqueror of Henman, and then Nicolas Lapenti from Ecuador to set up this final appearance. And he really has looked extremely good, Thomas Enqvist, in all parts of his game. Yevgeny Kafelnikov, born and lives in Sochi in Russia, 25 next month, as I've said, world ranked number 10. Three titles last year, was London in Doha and Moscow. And his round through, pretty straightforward, beat another Swede in the first round there. Jim Courier having to retire. Stoltenberg was the turning match for him, Kafelnikov says in interviews. He played extremely well against what has to be said, the inexperienced Tommy Haas in the semi-final to secure his route through to the final. Australian being given the match, so it's a big, big day for all concerned here. And that match that he played against Jason Stoltenberg, Danny, for Kafelnikov, he said that literally turned his whole tournament around. He found his real form.
Yeah, that's right. I think when he came into the tournament, wasn't on the best of form, didn't have the utmost of confidence. But in a Grand Slam, it is 7 matches, and you do need to play yourself into form. And he has said in his post-match conferences that that was the turning point, and since then he really has been on top form.
Thomas Enqvist here, looking to become the first Swede to win here since Mats Wilander in 1988. Stefan Edberg was runner-up in 93 here, and for this man, Yevgeny Kafelnikov, he's looking to become the first Russian to lift the title. And when these two both played together in the Australian Open, the last time they did both play here together was in 96, they both made the quarterfinals. For Kafelnikov here, he missed 1997 with a broken finger on his right hand, and last year couldn't play because of a left knee sprain. So this one really is going to be a tight one to call. 17 titles for Yevgeny Kafelnikov in his career so far. One slam, of course, that the 1996 French Open. Thomas Enqvist, 14 career titles, head-to-head confirmation. 14 career titles, and significantly, Thomas Enqvist, he's unbeaten this year. He won the opening tournament of his 1999 campaign, Adelaide, and he won the Colonial Classic, the exhibitions in Kooyong a week later. So he had to experience defeat this year. Tactically, Danny, how do you see this one panning out? Because in a way, they're both very similar, aren't they?
Yeah, if ever there was the case of playing a mirror image of yourself, this would be it. Both players very reliant on heavy ground strokes from the back of the court. Both serve very heavy, not huge, but sufficient to gain the advantage early on in the service points. The only factor for me is I feel Kafelnikov, if necessary, has the ability to approach the net. He's certainly more comfortable than Enqvist at the net, so I think if there is going to be a deciding factor, I think that could just swing it the Russians' favour. But very difficult to call.
There were rankings going into this match. Yevgeny Kafelnikov at number 10 and seeded 10. Thomas Enqvist is world ranked at 21. And we know how good Thomas Enqvist can be. He was number 6 in February of 96. As we look at new coach for Yevgeny Kafelnikov from January this year, Larry Stefanke really has done a fine job. They asked Thomas Enqvist in the press conferences who approached who in terms of the relationship, and I think it was more on Yevgeny's side when he knew he'd stopped working with Marcelo Rios. So the back two-thirds of last year, I thought it would be a good idea for them to get together. But he thought he'd leave it till the start of the year. Whole new start, fresh approach, different motivations, a real challenge. And I know that Larry Stefanke has really worked on getting Yevgeny to become a lot more aggressive. That's the key word. I think that's going to be important again today too, particularly on the return of service games against Enqvist.
Yeah, that's right. I know Larry Stefanke has a very, very good reputation. He won't take less than 100% from his charge on the court. And it is a factor where Kafelnikov has suffered in the past. He's obviously doing a very good job here. And he's also helps Kafelnikov to relax off the court. They both enjoy playing golf. And it's very nice to share the same off-court interests. Just builds the relationship further.
As you mentioned, off-court interests. So Thomas Enqvist, he enjoys playing soccer. And what's it called, Danny? This floor hockey?
It's a very exotic sounding game. It's called Unibandy, which I believe is a form of indoor hockey.
I know Julian Carr, where I work at Cumberland Tennis Club. Julian Carr, who tried to play the pro circuit for a while, a very good tennis player. She's a very good Unibandy player, so I didn't know it even existed in the UK, but clearly it does. She's a fine exponent of it as well, they say. Well, she says, I'm not so sure. Only kidding, Gillian, if you're listening. As I said, Thomas Enqvist, he had a foot injury last year and it limited to 17 tournaments only. So he is really hungry for success and I think that could be significant here. He really is a class act. He has been, not only for these 2 weeks, but in all his matches that he's played at the start of the year to keep that unbeaten record going. And I think the key is, will Yevgeny Kafelnikov be able to get a break of serve? Kafelnikov's doubles ranking has been as high as number 4. I think that will come into the match too. He's got the ability to return well, and he's going to need to. So the stage is set. Yevgeny Kafelnikov will get us underway. Thank you.
Michael.
Early on, both players playing within the lines, giving themselves plenty of margin for error in the early stages. I'm sure we'll soon see them begin to open their shoulders.
So early on in the match.
Yeah, definitely setting very early, both players. They are so full of confidence though, I wouldn't expect anything less.
This is going to be a good match. There's going to be a lot of good tennis here.
It's always a key indication of nerves if you see a double hander playing the slice with the one hand. He hasn't quite got his feet moving yet.
First ace of the match, his 59th of the tournament. So pretty good start for Yevgeny Kafelnikov. He'll be pleased with that. He takes the opening game and leads one love here in the Australian Open final. Important, of course, in the final to get underway on the scoreboard as quickly as you can, and Thomas Enqvist will be hoping to do just that at love one down.
15 love.
Well, still a bad start. First ace for him, and the 76th for him in the tournament. I've got this gut feeling that this match is more about Kafelnikov than it is about Enqvist. Enqvist will just do exactly what he's done every round. Now, opening service game, Kafelnikov coming into the net twice. I think that is significant. He knows, in my view, that he's not going to beat Enqvist from the back. And straight away, this point I made about how is he going to break Enqvist's serve is endorsed in this opening service game. Good start for the Swede.
Yep, he'll be happy with that.
Interesting, hasn't it, Danny, listening to the guys in the interview room after matches and so on, and in the preview to the final. What's interesting for me was Yevgeny Kafelnikov's comment that he's got to stay with this man early on. And that gives an indication as to how he feels about the match generally.
Yeah, he knows his opponent's right on the top of form, very confident player. He did stress that he didn't want to go a break behind early, and he's in danger of doing just that. But he does need to knuckle down early on. Felt, I really felt the way Kafelnikov was preparing for that forehand. He was going to take it on up the line and come in behind it. I'm sure Enquist felt the same way, wrong-footed with the forehand cross-court.
Stay that time. A little look at Enquist there from Kafelnikov. It's interesting early on, just checking the mental state of play. Both men have started well, and already this match, which is full of interest before it started, has lived up to its promise in the very early stages.
Yeah, we were talking earlier about the post-match conferences. I know Kafelnikov was remaining very tight-lipped about tactics, but he did hint at the fact that this man here, Thomas Enquist, was known in the past to choke slightly tighten up in the really critical situations. And I'm not saying he is a choker, but if Kafelnikov is gaining any sort of psychological advantage by thinking that, then that's good from his point of view. Anything you can glean from your opponent's weaknesses to help your own cause in cases such as this.
That on court. 1-2, first set. It's 34th double of the tournament, Thomas Enquist.
15-0.
If Yevgeny Kafelnikov for a split second was thinking, uh-oh, maybe getting a bit tight, immediately, mentally, a bit of a seesaw with the response.
Smart play from the Russian. It wasn't an intentional approach, but he saw his opponent in trouble, tried to close the net down.
So flat, doesn't he? Sort of the grip, his way round to the left there as we look at his coach, Mikhail Stripple. Just fairly thumped that away. Clear in his mind, it's just a case of him executing it, isn't it?
I'm sure when he sees Enquist forced into the single hand up, Kafelnikov really trying to close the net down.
Oh. this has been the problem for all of Enquist's opponents the whole fortnight.
That's right, formality's over. Now it's down to work for Thomas Enquist. Takes that backhand so early, finding the outside of the line.
Yeah, holds his head. I mean, the key to this guy's ground strokes is great footwork, and with no sign of injuries plaguing him, his footwork has been impeccable.
That's two missed returns off second serves there from Thomas Enquist. I'm sure he won't be happy with that.
So good recovery from the Russian from love 30 down. Three very quick points, three returns missed. That'll give him heart. Pretty a temporary blip. Look at the footwork, lad.
He did very well to move out of the way of this one. Body serve. Power in that forehand.
Even when he's moving away from the ball, he keeps his upper body so beautifully balanced, doesn't he? He never leans backwards. It's a poor miss. And a real skip from Kafelnikov after it. Just the first real sign of any tension. And the first chance for the Swede.
Game in question.
Well, that's a shame to lose the serve on a double fault. Coach DeFanke won't be too pleased with that. It's his 25th double fault of the tournament, his first in the match. Enquist 3-2, first set. Thomas Enquist has got the early break, he leads 3-2 in the opening set. Strange, Kafelnikov really only returning down the middle of the court. He's not going to get much change out of the Swede if he continues with that.
Second serve doing the damage there. A little extra pace, a little extra width.
He really couldn't do much else other than just block it back, could he, Kafelnikov, really? Second love game of the set. And his fourth ace.
Well, if Kafelnikov thought that extra Grand Slam title under his belt would hold him in good stead, we're having different thoughts now. It started so well, Thomas Enquist.
Margin. Another look again at Mikhail Strippel, coach to Enquist.
He does hit the ball so hard and so flat, Thomas Enqvist, especially off the forehand wing. Consequently, has to aim a lot lower over the net, therefore his margin of error is that much smaller than the Russians.
Certainly be pleased with that game, Kafelnikov, but early thoughts as they sit down here. Danny, what do you think both guys are thinking right now?
Well, I think it's quite clear that Enqvist will be the more comfortable of the two. There's obviously the break ahead. He does look very comfortable on serve. Kafelnikov, I think it's quite clear that his game plan is to try and get into the net on the Enqvist backhand, especially if he can make Enqvist hit the single-handed slice backhands. And again, that's not going too badly. He has come in a few times, missed a couple of volleys, but it hasn't been through Enqvist hitting great passing shots. So I think they're both going to be fairly relaxed. It's just a question of whether Kafelnikov can get back into this set, or he's just going to have to start again at the start of the second. But it's very early days. I think they'll both be relatively happy with both of their starts.
Yevgeny Kafelnikov has moved up to number 5 in the new lists that will be coming out on Monday. If he were to win, he'd be up to number 3 in the world. For Thomas Enqvist, he's moved up to number 11 from 21. And if he were to win, he'd go as high as number 8, so back in the top 10, where he belongs, of course. So, new balls. 4-3, first set.
Definitely seeing a lot more errors off the Kafelnikov racket here today.
It's this problem we talk about on the return. I think he's just got to throw caution to the wind and try and read the serve early and make big returns. Just unsettling, Chris. We really lost that point, but it's another classic Enqvist point. He gets to dominate with his first ground stroke after his serve. He won't be happy with that, but this return is so important.
I think it just highlights the earlier point we made that Thomas Enqvist isn't a natural volleyer. Well, he dealt with that one marginally better.
Yeah, only marginally, you're right.
I'm sure Kafelnikov will make him play every single volley possible when he does approach the net.
It wears you down though, doesn't it? When you're under the cosh each rally, which he's been really in all of these points in this game. Enqvist has controlled all of them. It's not easy. Again, only a token sort of effort on the return. It's not easy, of course, but definitely say gamble. Is he going backhand or forehand to the body? Try and gamble it. Make an early move and try to hit a quality return. So to stay in the opening set, Yevgeny Kafelnikov serving 3-5.
15 long.
Oh!
It's more like it. Kafelnikov himself using his forehand to great effect. Again, takes it so early. Depth doing the damage on that occasion. Again low there, Kafelnikov. Slice return staying very low.
Still managed to get something on that return though, didn't he, Enqvist, even with just the one hand. Second ace for the Russian. He's made Thomas Enqvist serve for the opening set. Stay with us here on Eurosport to see if he can do just that. 30 on Enqvist's last service game. He's got to remind himself of that, but again, for me, he's got to gamble as Enqvist serves for the first set.
15 long.
He's not guessing, is he? He's waiting for the serve to be hit and then reacting. That will not break the serve.
Well, if he's going to falter through nerves, it will be in this game, serving for the first set. I'm sure Kafelnikov realises that. That's where you can't guess, because the variation is so good.
Guessing though is so important, Danny, because even if you go completely the wrong way, it makes the server think that he's serving so well. And you know that's the oldest trick in the book. If you say to your opponent, God, he's serving so well today, normally they serve worse. So even going completely the wrong way, it wouldn't be a bad thing necessarily. Daniela there on the right, clapping her applause, girlfriend to Thomas Enqvist, as he gets his first set point.
It's just the heavier weight of shot again doing the damage.
Kafelnikov, there's no prizes for guessing what he's thinking right now.
And it will give him a huge boost if he believes that his opponent is faltering.
And he just can't get this return away from the middle of the court often enough.
That ball was a blur for me off that forehand. Hit with such pace, really catching it at the top of the bounce. Oh.
he's got Engqvist skying around the baseline like that, but he'll be delighted to see it at least a couple of times. Especially as it produced the error.
Well, he read the wide serve there. Couldn't keep the ball in play though. Obviously very disappointed, as we heard.
Maybe third time lucky for Thomas Engqvist. It was long the moment he hit it. No argument at all. First Grand Slam title. He wouldn't be human if he didn't. Break point for the 10th seed. Nose is wide though, the smile says it. Knows how close it was to getting the break. His first set is fully charged. Both going for their shot still. They've been such great support to all the Swedish players here down under for a long, long time. So on his fourth set point, the 24-year-old Swede sets up base camp. Now he's got to think about the assault on the summit. 6-4 in just over half an hour's play. First blood to Thomas Engqvist.
I don't think Kafelnikov will be too disappointed with that game. Engqvist definitely showing signs of faltering. That will definitely draw strength from that in later stages. That was a poor double fault there from the Russian. Boy, barely reaching halfway up the net.
So now you remember all the things he said in the press conference. Got to get off to a good start. I really want to win the first set. Those things have gone against him. So he's got to rethink his whole plan of attack.
15-0.
There's so many things similar about these guys coming in. Their game plans. The fact that their last three matches have been straight sets, straight sets. In the last two, and the one before that was a fifth set match. So fatigue certainly won't be a problem. Same age, both been top 10.
I think it's quite apparent that Engqvist does have the greater weight of shot. I think it's up to Kafelnikov to use his variation, such as this backhand here, drawing his opponent out of court. Can see Kafelnikov on the back foot as often as he has been in this match.
pace and direction. Third ace in the match for the Russian. Followed by his fourth. That was a huge gain for Yevgeny Kafelnikov, and he's done well to come through it. He can now sit down and rethink his game plan. Join us after the break.
We could serve for Thomas Enqvist, 2-3 in the opening set, enough to win the first set. He survived break points at 5-4 serving for it, but he now trails love one second set.
Interesting.
A change of approach from the Russian. Looking to rush his opponent off the second serve. He obviously feels that he is on the receiving end of most of the baseline rallies.
It's interesting that Thomas Enqvist then immediately looked to come in himself to equalise it almost.
He does like to wrong-foot his opponents as well, Thomas Enqvist. Kafelnikov guessing right this time, or reading the situation well. Again, slightly uncomfortable at the net.
This is fascinating now. It's like a game of chess, and for any youngsters out there watching, the key has been the time spent at the last change of ends.
Definitely trying to break up the Swede's rhythm. Definite frailties in the volley. Very sensibly bringing the Swede into the net.
Yeah, he got it all wrong, didn't he? Just slapped over the top.
And it's one break point saved. With his seventh ace of the match already, but he's got two more to face.
I think that's poor from Kafelnikov. On numerous occasions he's been caught by the extra pace on the second serve. Should possibly give himself an extra half a yard further back, give himself that split second longer to react.
From Yevgeny Kafelnikov. With absolutely no doubt, we've seen so many times Yevgeny Kafelnikov go walkabout in matches. There's no way is he going to do that here. He's straight back in the match with a break and leads 2-love. The whole fortnight, you've only got a break of serve when you then hold your own to make your man serve again. Enter our competition here. Who's going to win this match and in how many sets on www.eurosport.com. Talkline.com, our website address.
Lovely backhand again. Kafelnikov well on the back foot. He really has to stay in control this game. Well, he had the opportunity again, just catching the tape with the backhand.
So I think maybe he's missing those volleys as he has done. That was on his mind as he played the shot. Had an influence on the execution.
You see there, Kafelnikov not scared of approaching the net. Looking to close it down there.
Sad in a way that it had to end with a losing shot.
I think Kafelnikov will definitely draw strength from this rally. Exchanging from the back with Enquist, finding himself with the opportunity, taking it well.
That's a good save from Kafelnikov from love 30 down, four straight points. In a view of Daniela, your girlfriend of Thomas Enquist, looking a little bit more pensive now. Kafelnikov secures the break and leads by three games to love, second set. So love 3, second set.
So the only thing we haven't seen in terms of variation was the high floaty ball with a little bit more topspin. That last forehand resembled that shot, forcing the error. Fascinating match to watch.
It really is. Kafelnikov's done well, isn't he? Because he's done enough to just unsettle the Swede. Being the bigger return, reaping the reward, it sets up three further chances for a second break. Game. Well, what a turnaround we're seeing here. This is quite amazing.
I bet at this stage, Enquist is glad that he held on at the end of that first set. Otherwise, things really could have swung round.
I would never have guessed that scoreline after the first set.
I think the fact that Enquist did falter in that final game of the first set definitely gave Kafelnikov heart. Just confirmed his beliefs that Enquist wasn't the big match player at the critical stages.
15.
Third double. Do you think he'll be quite happy to let this set go now and just recharge for the third set, or not?
Well, it certainly looks that way. I'm sure he's going to have a long, hard think at this next change of ends. He has to try and collect his thoughts. I don't feel that Kafelnikov is going to let this match slip away now. I think Enquist is going to have to really fight his way back into it.
Really not interested on those last 2 points. Fifth ace for Yevgeny Kafelnikov and five straight games. This match is turning into a real battle. Don't miss a ball of it. We'll be back after the break. Five love. Down in the second set, Enquist about to serve.
15 love.
I think he'll want to get his game back on track now, Thomas Enquist. He won't want to lose a love set and allow his opponent to begin serving in the third. At his best, playing from the front, he's on the front runner.
15,
I think he quite noticeably speeds up his play when he's ahead as well, Kafelnikov. Really turns the screws.
Two doubles and one ace in the game so far. Sure, that due to thoughts going towards the third set, which, if this point is won by Kafelnikov, will happen. It's a bit of a gift. You don't worry about that. Stefanke has got his man back on level terms. We're a set apiece in an enthralling, intriguing final here. Six love set, but it wasn't all one-way traffic. Thomas Enquist had a few chances against the Kafelnikov serve. And already this match a lot better than some of the previous finals here at the Australian Open. Notably the last 2 years, both matches have been straight set victories for Peter Korda last year against Rios 2-2 and 2, and the year before Pete Sampras beating Carlos Moya 6-2, 6-3, 6-3. So the Australian crowd here are in for a treat. New ball, start of the third set.
Ah.
Umpire confirming the call of the lineswoman. Just missed on the sideline.
He's read it so well the whole match, hasn't he, Engqvist? Knows where his man's going virtually every shot.
Got such a high elbow on that take back, Kafelnikov. No man's land there. He knows the importance of this game. He wants to keep the momentum rolling. Well, his aces haven't been as prolific as his previous match, but he really has served well on the big points.
Matches are all seesaw now. It is so tough to pick a winner.
Thomas Enqvist doing well to generate pace off this ball, off the slice from Kafelnikov, to generate it all on his own. Very dangerous coming into Enqvist on the backhand. If he can get two hands on the racket, it does enable him to have a good swing at a pass such as that. Point there, Enqvist had the opportunity to approach the net on the earlier ball, chose not to. There was no pressure on Kafelnikov at all. He made the subsequent defensive shot, and then when Enquist did approach, he was forced into the error. So it does help to be able to approach the net, but that added pressure on your opponent.
Low ball again, that wasn't easy.
Did well to generate pace and get the angle to force Enquist out of court.
Has been going just about on the hour as the courtside clock shows there. Both men have set up base camp. Who's going to reach the peak first? We'll be back. Winning game out of the last seven is serving at love one in the third set. Easy making a smash from that end, is it?
The sun and the bright blue sky, very difficult to contend with.
To the end of a set to give it away six love. He's gone one love down, that's seven straight games. Becomes a problem if he loses a serve here, doesn't it?
Variation, really trying to upset the Swede's rhythm. He's doing it well, isn't he?
Severe pressure right here, the 24-year-old. Let's look at Mikael Strippel, coach to Enquist. He's remained passive throughout. Most of the great Swedish coaches always have done. Lennart Berglund, fine example of that, of course. Chances for Kafelnikov to win his eighth straight game, but more importantly, go a break up third set. You can't believe there wasn't a call.
I think Kafelnikov did very well there. He could have easily turned his back, knowing that Enquist's backhand was going wide. Actually hit the side of the net post and came back into court. It's quite a strange point here. Right just inside, that ball was landing about 3 metres wide. Came back off the net post. So the run continues. Eight straight games for the Russian.
Oh. Pressure's changed again, you know, we're just clapping the call. Pressure's changed again, hasn't it? He's now got the break. So once he's saying to himself, I've got the break, he might then relax a little bit. It really is that close, this match.
Taking on a lot of balls, Thomas Enquist. Definitely making more errors than I'm used to seeing him make. Just feel he's just got to stand toe to toe for a couple of games with Kafelnikov and exchange from the back. Really give nothing away.
Seems like two or three strings have gone on that shot. Right in the middle.
Yep. By the power these two are hitting the ball, you would expect it. These strings taking a real pounding here today.
There's two strings gone.
Looks like it's gone at the top there. Maybe slightly missed hit this back end. Got a feeling we're going to see some very long rallies very soon. Don't think Enquist is going to want to give any cheap points away.
Yeah, just what he was pretty good. Looked wide to me.
No complaint from Enquist. Oh, it did look wide.
To bite straight back.
Juice. Slightly slower serve, a bit more height and a bit more spin.
Daniela certainly going through it now. Right on the line. Yep, confirmed by the Russian. Feel as well these men have got such respect for each other. Just wide again on the down the line shot. Again, he's going for the line on that down the line shot when he's near the line himself, the other end. So dangerous, of course. Got nothing to aim at. Thank you.
securing the breaker serve, Yevgeny Kafelnikov now, 3-love in the third set. I thought before the match his problem would be to break the Swedish man's serve. He's done that on the last four occasions in a row. Join us for more action after this.
Kafelnikov really turning the tables here and tightening the screw. It's 3-love in the third set. The breaker serve, Thomas Enqvist to serve next.
Enqvist did start the match very well, which makes this capitulation even more unbelievable. Full credit to the Russian though. Solid base to hit from.
I think that is ninth ace.
He desperately needs to get a game on the scoreboard, Thomas Enqvist, just to stop the rot.
Just wide.
Once again, Enqvist able to get the two hands on the backhand. Makes the pass so much easier.
Game in.
Loudest cheer of the match so far from the Swedish contingent. But we're hoping it's a significant game. Passes don't get much better than that.
He's at full stretch there. His forehand on the run. Did well to direct it with pace down the line.
Seen that shot since the opening set.
It's very clear that Larry Stefanke has given the orders to break up the rhythm. really upset the rhythm of the Swede, which he's trying to do here, bringing him forward to the net. Drop shot wasn't good enough though. He paid the price.
Chance to get back in this third set. So just when you thought Yevgeny Kafelnikov was going to run away with it, Thomas Enqvist has raised his concentration and his willpower in this third set. He's broken back to trail by 3-2.
It's one of the toughest matches to pick in the whole fortnight. Super that it should be in the final. Thomas Enqvist, 2-3, third set.
Those unforced errors, Thomas Enqvist. He's giving away far too many cheap points at this stage.
It's a great shot.
It's one of his best shots, he's backhand up the line, Thomas Enqvist.
First time he's made it in quite a while. There's a message in there somewhere.
Not the body serve doing the damage. Needs to take out some frustration on this smash though. He's done well though. Kafelnikov hasn't led him back in this set. He's really forced his way back.
His arm, in my view, for the success rate he's had on that shot. He's losing too many points. Emphatic call. One of the loudest. Fighters, aren't they? They know that this game, you know, having had 40-15, get back to juice, to make an unforced error there. Kafelnikov is kicking himself. There's just so little in this match, and it's no doubt going to come down to the one with the tougher mental spirit.
Definitely, when two players do play very similar styles of play, very important to get the mental ascendancy and keep it. We've seen it swing from both players in this match, but now it's very finely balanced.
almost pleased to have made the backhand down the line, and it led him to being late on the forehand.
I think Kafelnikov did very well with his forehand in reply to this shot. Got great depth and width.
He thought he had a less serve. He asked Wayne McHugh in the chair umpire for this match in the second set whether or not the machine was switched on for the Letts.
Beginning to find his range with the backhand up the line. Bring his opponent out of court, creating the opening.
So early, and he had a great balance base for the shot.
Read the shot so well again from Kafelnikov, choosing to cover the backhand up the line. A huge difference there, second set winners from Enquist, as the score suggests.
If that ball had hit him before it bounced, he would have lost the point, so quite rightly jumping over it. Break point for four straight games.
Just seems to save those aces for the really critical points. Does Yevgeny Kafelnikov? Sign of a true champion. Comes up with the goods in the crunch situations. Damage on this shot. It's relatively more straightforward. Still had to deal with it though. Crucial seventh game. I think they're all crucial from here on in.
The occasion and he just takes that four a fraction late.
Really using the full dimensions of the court though with the angles.
Tough game for both guys. Eventually Kafelnikov it is, who comes through, and he leads by 4-3 here in this third set. He's delicately poised at one set apiece. We'll be back for more action after the break. Thomas Enqvist 3-4 third set.
Soaked up the early pressure, kept a good length, and then turned up the power when he himself had a good opportunity.
As he's saying, the upper body just back jackknifing away. And get another look on the right there of Daniela. And in the front with the cap, Mikhail Strippel in the Enqvist camp. Great team to serve your 12th ace. That's a big miss.
And he knows it as well. Closes his eyes in desperation. It was a good opportunity there for Thomas Enqvist.
Yeah, just helping the linesman if they needed any help. Double break point for the 24-year-old.
Tentative there from the Russian. Couldn't keep a good depth off the ground.
They're keeping their tempo going, aren't they? Oh, that's the second forehand he's put long in the game. There's daylight again in this third set. Kafelnikov will serve to take a 2-1 lead.
Kafelnikov leads, 5-3.
I must say, I thought the match would be full of more points won by both men, but at the moment, since that first set, most points are being lost, aren't they? Such is the tension. Strange choice there. It's almost like he was still thinking about whether or not his lob was going to go in. It's been overruled from Wayne McEwen, the Australian umpire. The judge to hit the line. Look at it again here.
Very difficult to tell from that angle. No argument from Kafelnikov. Very little argument.
Staring at 40-15 to the overall. Kirby's now got a break back chance.
Oh. It was tough to see.
It's good that he can smile about it.
Both players dealing with the disappointment of believing they'd won the point very well.
Thomas Enqvist, sure that ball was wide, but deciding just to ignore it and get on with it. I think that's a smart decision. So from break point down, has a chance to take a 2-1 lead here in the final. And he needs one bite at it. A look to Stefanke. Clenched fist. Yevgeny Kafelnikov has come from a set down. He leads by 2-1 here in Melbourne.
Events last year, which is a huge amount by anybody's standards. And I was listening to Larry Stefanke talk, and he said that we want to cut down on the quantity and we want to improve the quality. I think it's very smart talking from the coach. It's very difficult to stay fresh for that number of tournaments. I believe he's really reaping the rewards very early in the year of playing less tennis. He started the year well. The arena here in Melbourne Park. I'm sure the 16,000 capacity crowd enjoying every moment of this final.
So new balls. Thomas Enqvist has got to come from 2-1 down if he's to win his first Grand Slam title.
15 on.
Had a lot of success with this wide serve in this final. Just slightly unhappy with his timing in this game, Yevgeny Kafelnikov, as he can't centre the ball on the racket.
Start in the fourth set, Thomas Enqvist. Even though there's a controversial end to it.
I wasn't sure.
Wayne McKeown says so, he can't intervene. So Thomas Enqvist, who has yet to have to come back from two sets to one down in any match here in the Australian Open. Stay with us to see if he can do it in the final. Beautiful day here in Melbourne, 28 degrees, a cloudless sky, not too humid, but it's hot on court. One love, Kafelnikov, he trails fourth set. That one, doesn't he? That's a smart move, isn't it? Just to rehearse the shot again. So how can he improve it next time is the message there.
There through the timing of the shot, didn't really have time to move his feet a huge amount.
managed to keep his nose in front. Obviously the pressure on him to do that now for the remainder of the match, having to come from behind. Press there, sitting courtside. It's a huge event. 1-2, fourth set.
15.
Inquis doing well to generate the pace of the slice from Kafelnikov.
That's pretty high on the ace count now.
Great placement from the Russian, right on the tee. Unfortunately, Inquis couldn't capitalise on the early advantage. The Russians soaked up the pressure well.
Okay, there's another point as well, isn't it, that ended with a loser. It's like their concentration, they take it in turns, so their concentration just a slip. In the game in the exact same spot. 2-all, fourth set.
2-all.
Persisted with it, even after the early errors. He obviously feels it is within his capabilities. I'm glad he came in as well. He saw the opportunity was there. Just puts that little bit extra pressure on your opponent if you're at the net.
Game in Portage.
He's keeping on putting his nose in front, Thomas Enqvist. Serving first in this set, of course, will help that. It's still anybody's match. It's a tough one to pick. We'll be back after this short break. He's put quite a few of the backhand returns into the net, hasn't he? That just feigning of the racket in front of him there, almost suggesting the left hand is just smothering the racket over the ball a bit. Perhaps.
I think he does consider his returns as one of his strengths. It's just more frustration that Kovalnikov is serving so well.
3-0, fourth set. Just did him for pure pace, didn't it? It wasn't that far away from him.
No, barely a couple of inches from the racket there. The net down so well there. Kovalnikov. Once again, the added pressure of the incoming player. That's just a little edge in Kovalnikov's favour at the moment. Pass would be suicide. Deciding just to place it at Kovalnikov's feet and wait for the second ball.
Too bad it was so much earlier, didn't he?
It's one of the first returns he has hit down the line as well. I'm sure it's slightly wrong-footing the Swede. 3-1.
23 all, 30 all. What a big point. I couldn't have been far long. Doing well, isn't he? Staying tough mentally. The Swedish camp applauding their man back to the chair. He leads 4-3, fourth set.
Winner, Pat Rafter. Give it with the British fans. I think they would have booked their return home on the middle weekend. No disrespect to Tim and Greg.
3-4, fourth set. Pick the right ball for the down the line on that point, that's for sure. Just feeling raising the tempo again, Thomas Enqvist.
Definitely a significant point for the Swede. Had to cope with the slices and the high loopy balls, which he did so very well.
Good as well up until that last one. I was amazed he didn't go down the line.
Yeah, we talked about the game resembling a game of chess. Certainly these last 2 points have been very cagey. Perfect shot selection to that one. Like you say, there was the opening up the line.
Waiting for the call, yeah, I think he was. Golden rule, into a called out, play every ball. He certainly waited for the call on that shot.
Yeah, it was a very high volley as well. Had to generate all the pace himself there.
Some time they make it, they serve five each until that point. I was wrong, it's six for Kafelnikov before, they're now seven. Chances in that game, I thought, Thomas Enqvist, but choices of shot just letting him down when it mattered most.
And significantly, the slice to the Enqvist forehand again causing the trouble. We've seen that in previous matches.
Not often, I've been crying for it for a fortnight. This match getting scary right now for Thomas Enqvist. Seven minutes match duration thus far. Oh.
play. Just the extra dimension of the person coming to the net just puts a little bit more pressure on the backhand. That's where the majority of the aces have come. Lindquist, wide to the forehand, to the deuce side. Reaching new heights. Great running pass cross court from Kravelnikov.
Super game from Thomas Enqvist. A little prodding of the head there, urging himself on. That was a tough game. He's come through with flying colours. He leads 5-4 in the fourth set. Kravelnikov at 4-5 down.
Casual there from the Russian. I think the fact that Thomas Enqvist had guessed the right way as well could have just made him take his eye off the ball.
That's tough. And the score is really staring at him in the face. He's staying focused. Tension with every shot in that point.
He was very much on the defensive for most of the rally. Furious that he couldn't get that ball over the net.
Again, the press conference, Kravelnikov, when asked about Tommy Haas, said that what he's got to learn is playing the right shot on the big points. Certainly the wrong ones for Thomas Enqvist.
Definitely catching that backhand very late. That's the extra height of the second serve. Blake could be his last.
5-4 fourth set.
Definitely increased over the last couple of games. as you might expect, reaching the climax of this fourth set.
Shot goes over from there. He's not winning the point with that shot. It's just too risky for me to play it. You need to be so selective when you go down the line. As he's simulating to himself there, again just urging himself on, dismissing those two blips on the backhand side. He's talked himself into that ace superbly.
It's really important when you are feeling tight to go back to where you know your strengths are, which obviously is the wide serve for Thomas Enqvist.
He really wants this title. Two aces in a row, and he keeps the pressure up on the Russian. He's taken a 6-5 lead here in the fourth set. Who will buckle first in the Melbourne Heat? Stay with us and find out after we take this short break. Thank you. About to watch Evgeny Kafelnikov serve to stay in this fourth set for the second time. It's the scoreline. So positively off his chair, hasn't he?
He did, and he dealt with that very high smash very comfortably. Thought we might see him let it drop there.
Overall, Thomas Enqvist not happy, but at least he got the overall. Players always respect if the chair umpire calls it quickly. It was well in.
Looked inside the line. Very good overall. Game again, Evgeny Kafelnikov, under extreme pressure, having to serve to stay in the set.
second service ace. His 15th. We thought the tension was getting bad, but as we head into this tie break, we ain't seen nothing yet. Yeah, the tie break records clearly in Kafelnikov's favour.
Fortunately, he did let go of his racket. Not very close to one of the line judges. Too close to see from that angle.
Kafelnikov hasn't lost a tie break in these championships. Enqvist has. Against Philippoussis. First mini break for the Russian.
Slice to great effect for Kafelnikov. The times he has been in trouble, pushed it back nice and deep, giving his opponent no pace to work with.
Carl Stripple, Coach Twinkfist, still looks passive.
Fingers on the cup at the moment. Kafelnikov. Still only one mini break though.
A lot of hearts, and more so than girlfriend Daniela's. Sixth double. Thomas Enqvist. Five love now. Kafelnikov 2 points away from his second slam. Change ends now, 5-1.
That was a very tentative backhand from Kafelnikov. Be a long walk thinking about that one. I'm sure he'll have his mind firmly set and holding on to this next service point. Thank you.
Well, he knows. He must know he's there. He's got 5 championship points after that superb angled volley setting up the open court.
What a rally. Good topspin lob. Look at that angle. Enquist going around the net post but leaving the open court for the forehand.
A sad way to end the match, but enormous celebration for Yevgeny Kafelnikov. He's ended the brave challenge of Thomas Enquist to become the first unseeded player to win the Australian Open since Mark Edmondson achieved that in 1976. He salutes a generous Melbourne crowd on their feet for both men. It's a tight match, a tense battle, not the best of tennis, but enthralling to watch. Larry Stefanke will be delighted. His man has won the first Grand Slam of 1999 in 4 sets. 4-6, 6-love, 6-3, 7-6. And in the end, Danny, he just did enough, didn't he?
Yeah, I think it was a thoroughly deserved victory. And I know before the match he did question the temperament of Enquist on the big points. I think it was definitely shown there in that tie break. Couple of crucial double faults. It was a great match, full credit to both men, and a thoroughly deserved winner.
It's always an emotional time when a player has not been a prolific Grand Slam winner pulls it off. It means so much more, I think. Larry Stefanke absolutely delighted, and rightly so. His team is going to be one to be reckoned with for this year's race to the number one spot, which is as wide open as it's ever been. Pete Sampras is certainly struggling. Marcelo Rios has temperament problems and injury problems. Make no mistake, Thomas Enquist, he's a clear contender. He's back now to world ranked number 11. There's no doubt he can win titles this year if he stays injury free. And Yevgeny Kafelnikov is now world ranked number 3, the same as his all-time high back in November of 1996. Just bear with us if you want, thank
you. Well, there was a nice souvenir of the racket for someone. I think the shirt's staying in his bag. Maybe one of the ball kids. This is nice seeing all the ball kids in the background. Bit of payback for them. They've worked hard this fortnight. Must be great to see such good tennis courtside.
A sorry figure sitting there, Thomas Enquist, shaking his head, but he can be proud of his efforts in this fortnight, having come back from so many injury problems last year. It's a great start for him this year. Join us for more of the celebrations after the break.
Here to Melbourne Park after winning 2 tournaments already this year, and he's given us a wonderful display of not only tennis, but of outstanding sportsmanship. Our runner-up, Thomas Enquist of Sweden.
And rightly said from the MC there, a very popular figure in Australia, girlfriend Daniela. She'll be sad but delighted, mixed feelings for her. She knows her man is well back on top form. What terrific encouragement they have shown to the Swedish players throughout the fortnight. Receiving a check there. And this is what he had to say after the match.
First of all, I have to congratulate Yevgeny. You played too solid for me today, and you were the champion. Congratulations. I also like to thank my supporters, not only the... not only the Swedes, that's always been a lot of fun to play in front of, and it's been a nice tradition for them to come down here and watch us play, and everybody feels you're a great thing here in Australia. Thank you very much.
That's a nice touch. $361,000 Australian.
I also like to thank my fiance Daniela, my coach Michael, and the Wilkinson family, all the support, and thank you so much for this great weeks for me here in Australia. Next year, maybe I can go all the way. See?
Nice man, isn't he? That's a new development. Fiance Daniela.
Yeah, certainly made a lot of friends this fortnight, Thomas Enquist.
A terrific competitor. Well, in 1996 he won the French Open singles title with a straight sets win over Michael Stich. He's now collected his second Grand Slam singles crown. Our champion for 1999 from Russia, Yevgeny Kafelnikov.
Probably only sinks in when the MC actually announces he's won. It's quite a good feeling of that.
He won tournaments last year in London, Hull and Moscow. Made the finals of tournaments in Marseille and Tashkent, and at the Stuttgart Outdoor in the fourth round of the US Open, and came to Melbourne Park as the number 10 seed.
Popular winner, the first Russian to lift the trophy.
The men's singles champion for 1999.
The trophy it is.
The Australian Open.
Yes, checking now for Australian dollars, $722,000. That not important. The Grand Slam is what he wanted.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, now I really know what it takes and what it feels like to win another Grand Slam, because when I did win my first French Open final, I wasn't really thinking about it. It was just, you know, a quick moment, but now I can really enjoy it. And, you know, it's a great feeling. Meantime, I'd like to say thank you to the tournament director, Paul McNamee, for organizing such a wonderful event. All the sponsors who has a great job. And, you know, most important thing is, you know, that was the last tournament of this century, and I'm very happy to win it. meantime, I would like to say thank you to my coach, Larry. He's been great to me, and my family, which is back home right now, my wife, my two daughters. It belongs to me, it belongs to them, and especially to my grandfather, who passed away this December. Unfortunately, he wouldn't share with me that pride of joy. And, you know, last message is to one person, Pete. You know, it's really great, wonderful feeling. Thanks for letting me do that.
For a lovely speech, obviously referring that a Pete Sampras' withdrawal from the tournament. Further words?
And many thanks to the fans, not only my Russian fellows, but all over the world. It's been great for support. Thanks a lot. I'll see you guys next year.
And pretty emotional, Yevgeny Kafelnikov. And there is a Russian presence here at Melbourne Park.
Gentlemen, I think you'll agree, a worthy champion, Yevgeny Kafelnikov, who will now pose for the world's press here on centre court after winning the Australian Open Men's Singles Championship for 1999.
That's from
the
kangaroo.
Two very nice speeches there for the two players. Guess they get lots of practice, played in many finals.
And ladies and gentlemen, just as you're leaving the stadium,
there's just for 2 minutes.
There's a concert out in the gardening closing area.
Has got the year off to a good start. There's been a lot of highlights in the 2 weeks here in the men's championship. Philippoussis Chang, that was a great match. The arrival of Leighton Hewitt, the young 17-year-old teenager sensation. He now going to team up with Darren Cahill on a permanent basis and travel the world circuit. There's been a lot of good tennis here over the last 2 weeks in both the men and the women's tournaments. And the circuit will now move back into Europe. Yevgeny Kafelnikov, how will he feel tomorrow morning when he wakes up, Danny? Will he feel flat?
I'm sure he will. It takes such a lot of emotion and nervous tension out of you when you win a tournament. I'm sure he'll be obviously excited, but very relieved that it's all over. It's only natural to be a little deflated. I'm sure when he hears all the interviews and reads the papers, it'll remind him of his great triumph.
And he'll certainly be celebrating back home in Sochi, in Russia. his birthplace and where he lives. Nice message for his wife and two kids, who I'm sure will be tuning in for this final. But he's come through against the Swedish player Thomas Enqvist. So we hope you've enjoyed the coverage of the Australian Open here on Eurosport International. We certainly have. From Jill Clark and Bob Hewitt, Danny Satsford and me, Chris Bradman, we leave you with the men's champion of 1999, Yevgeny Kafelnikov from Russia. The year off to a great start. Thanks for your company. From us, it's bye for now.
The Australian Open.